Next tutorial today I've got another project for you. This time is very big project. It's a tablecloth. As you can see, we need to work with small flowers and then we need to join them together to form our beautiful project. It's quite easy to do and you can make as big as long as you need to. During my tutorial I will show you how to join the flowers together and then how we need to work on the border. So basically the border, the whole pattern is staying the same for each size, so if you would like to make it small you can make less flowers per row, and if you want to make a big you need to make of course big more flowers per row. So for this tutorial I used crochet hook size 1.75 millimeters, and as you can see three different colors of crochet thread yarn. I will say that you will be probably need about three balls on each color, so that means you will need about 9 balls for my size. So as you can see I am making 6 flowers per row. It's quite hard to see now, but on the picture is easier, and I am making lots of rows, so yeah, I used about 3 balls per each color. As a first I will show you how to make the first flower. So we need to start working with a slip knot, then chain of 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Now slip stitch into the first chain stitch, so we've done ring, then chain of 1, this chain 1 is not count as any stitch, into the ring we will work 16 single crochets. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. At the end of our round we need to skip chain 1 space. We need to skip the first chain and slip stitch into the first single crochet. Now chain of 3, this is the first double crochet and another chain of 3 as a chain 3 space. Then we need to skip second stitch into the third one, so skip second into the third one double crochet. Chain of 3, skip first stitch into the second double crochet. Chain of 3, skip first stitch into the second double crochet. So now we need to repeat this pattern all the way around. At the end we should have 8 double crochets and 8 chain 3 spaces. At the end of our round, after the last chain of 3, we need to work slip stitch into the third chain. Round number 3. We need to start by making slip stitch into the chain space, then chain of 4 as a treble crochet, and into the same chain space we will work 3 more treble crochets. One, two, and 3. Now chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Our round we start by working 4 stitches into the first chain space and then into the second 4 treble crochets again. 1, 2 3 and 4. Chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Into the next chain space, 4 treble crochets as well. So now basically we need to repeat this pattern all the way around. In each chain space we will work 4 treble crochets, and between each group of 4 treble crochets we need to work chain of 7. So I am at after my last treble crochet, so now chain of 7, and we need to start repeat our pattern. At the end of our round, I've done the last chain of 7 and then slip stitch into the fourth chain. So now we start round number 4, and we need to start by working slip stitch into the second and into the third stitch. Chain 1 as a single crochet, then into the first chain space we will work 8 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, then chain 1 and another 8 double crochets into the same chain space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now single crochet into the third stitch. 1, 2, 3, single crochet. Into the next chain 7 space the same. 8 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Chain 1 and again 8 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Single crochet into the third stitch. So now we need to repeat our pattern in each chain 7 space, so we should have 8 petals at the end. Okay, so I've done 8 petals. My first flower is already done. So now we need to work the second. The second we will start exactly the same by making slip knot, chain of 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, slip stitch into the first chain stitch, chain 1, but it's not count as any stitch, and 16 single crochets into the ring. So now we need to repeat our pattern until we will have 6 petals done. The last 2 chain 2 spaces we need to leave empty, because the second flower we will be joining by working the last 2 petals. So from now, from the first round, we need to repeat our pattern, but the last 2 chain spaces we need to leave empty. Okay, so I've got my full 6 petals, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Into the 7th chain, I've done already 8 double crochets. So now, I am not making chain of 1, but I am taking my first flower and I will be joined. We need to find the space, so where we've done the chain of 1, and we need to, at the moment, join into the any petal. by working slip stitch, then chain of one, and we need to go back to our chain space and we will work another 8 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now we need to make single crochet into the third stitch, so exactly the same. Into the next chain space again, first 8 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now we are going into the second petal, so this is the first one, and now the second, and we need to find chain one again, and we are working slip stitch, and again into the chain space another 8 double crochets. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and 8, and then slip stitch into the first single crochet. So our second flower we've got done. Now we can fasten off and cut the yarn. So as you can see, we've joined two petals together. So now each one flower we will be joining to those two. So the top two and the bottom two we need to leave, and another flowers on this side, if we will be joining on this side at just at the bottom, we need to join to the two right ones. So we've got two lefts, two rights, two tops and two bottoms petals. I showed you how to join flower to the second one, so now you know how to join in this way, in the, like a first row. And now I will show you how to join the first flower of the next rows. So again, we need to work 6.5 petals. So after the chain of 8, I will join my flower to the top two petals. So we've done joining to the two right one, and now to the top. And now I will move, it will be a little bit easier for me. And again, after 8 double crochets, I am going into the chain one space, slip stitch, chain one, then I am going back to the chain space and I need to make another 8 double crochets. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, then single crochet into the third chain, 8 double crochets into the last chain space, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And now we need to go to the second petal and we will join into the chain one space again. Slip stitch, chain one, and into the chain space another 8 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. At the end, slip stitch into the first single crochet, and now we can fasten off and cut the yarn. So now we've joined 3 flowers together. So we know how to join on the sides rows, how to join into the first row, and then we need to find out how to join one more flower, so into the center. So now we need to repeat our pattern, but at the beginning we are working only full 4 petals, and then half the 5th one. The 3 chain spaces we need to leave empty, because now we will be joining 4 petals together, 2 on the right side, so this is exactly the same as we've done with the first row, and then 2 top ones with the 2 bottom ones as we've done here. So we need to have 4 petals to join. Okay, so as I said, I've done 4.5 petals, and now I will start joining. So first I will join into the top of right petal of the second flower over here, and again I need to find chain 1 space, slip stitch, chain 1, and 8 double crochets into the same chain space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 single crochet into the third stitch, then 8 double crochets into the next one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now I need to join into the second petal on the right side. So again, chain 1 space, slip stitch, chain of 1, and then another 8 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 single crochet into the third stitch. Into the next chain space, 8 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now slip stitch into the first top ones. So we've got 2. Slip stitch into the chain of 1 into the first one, chain of 1, and 8 double crochets into the same chain stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 single crochet into the third stitch, and 8 stitch and 8 double crochets into the last chain space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now slip stitch into the next petal. Chain 1 and 8 double crochets into the same chain space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Single crochet into the first single crochet. And now again, we can fasten off and cut the yarn. So now actually know how to join each flower into our table runner, because we've got the bottom ones, the sides ones, and then the center ones. So basically each one in the second, third, fourth row, we need to join exactly the same to the two right petals and two bottom, to the two top of the previous flower. But into each next flower we have to join two lefts and two bottoms. So now we've got one more thing to do. As you can see, we've got gap between four flower. So now I would like to show you what we need to do to fill this gap. At the moment, we will start by making slip knot. Then chain of 4. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Slip stitch into the first chain. So now we've got small ring. Chain of 3. 1, 2, 3. It will be first double crochet, and now we need to find the center of our ring, and we will work 15 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16. 15 actually, because we need to have 16 stitches. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16. 16 double crochets, because chain of 3 is count as a double crochet, and then slip stitch into the top of chain 3, into the first double crochet. Round number 2, chain of 1 as a single crochet, then chain of 3 as a chain 3 space. We need to skip first stitch, single crochet into the second. Chain of 3, skip first stitch, single crochet into the second. And again, chain of 3, skip first stitch, single crochet into the second. So now we need to repeat our pattern all the way around, and at the end we will have 8 single crochets and 8 chain 3 spaces. So now is the last one. 1, 2, 3. So as you can see, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and this one is 8. Slip stitch into the first chain, so into the first single crochet. Now next row round, slip stitch into the first two chain stitches, 1 and 2. So now we are exactly into the center of our chain space. Now chain of 2 and we need to grab our 4 flowers and we will start filling the gap. Now we need to find first petal and then we will start count each stitches 1, 2, 3, and 4. So into the 4th stitch I will work slip stitch. So I've done chain of 2, slip stitch into the 4th stitch, then chain of 2 again, single crochet into the next chain space. So here we've got first one and then into the next. Chain of 2, then we are going into the next petal. So this was the first one and now into the second. And again 1, 2, 3, and 4. Into the 4th chain, slip stitch, chain of 2, single crochet into the next chain space. Chain of 2. Now we are going into the second flower and into the first petal, 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4th double crochet, slip stitch, chain of 2. So now at the moment our work look like that. We've joined 3 petals, chain of 2, single crochet into the next chain space, and again chain of 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4th stitch into the next petal, slip stitch, chain of 2, and again single crochet into the next chain space, chain of 2, and we are going into the next petal, 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4th stitch, slip stitch, chain of 2, single crochet into the next chain space, chain of 2, and then next petal, 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4th stitch, slip stitch, chain of 2, single crochet into the next chain space, chain of 2. Now we've got the last one petal, 1, 2, 3, and 4, into the 4th stitch, slip stitch. So as you can see, I am working from the back, not from the front. And now we should have 8 petals joined, but as you can see, I skipped one. So we need to go back and I need to correct. So sometimes you need to make sure, because it's quite easy to miss one petal, but everything is staying exactly the same. I thought that I've done something wrong because I had 1 chain 3 space left, 2, 3, and 4, slip stitch, chain of 2, single crochet, chain of 2, 1, 2, 3, and 4, slip stitch. Now I will make sure that I've got all of them. Yes, now is correct. And now the last chain of 2 and we have none chain spaces left. Then we need to make slip stitch into the first chain, so into the single crochet, and now we can fasten off and cut our yarn. So now we can hide our tails and keep continue working on the pattern. So now again we need to add as many flowers as we need to and between each 4. So for example, now we will be adding another 2 flowers, so again we will be have gap here, so we can fill this gap by using this method. So now keep continue working on the pattern and until you will have the size as you want to, and then I will show you how we need to work on the border. Okay, so I've join my all flowers together, so now we need to start working with the border. So I'm going to my one of the corner flowers and I will join into the right, into the top right petal. So I'm going to the chain space, so into the center of the petal, and now we will need to make slip stitch. And actually at the beginning I am making little knot to secure the thread yarn. Okay, so chain one, so we've joined, and now chain of 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. Now single crochet, actually 15, because we need to work chain of one as a first single crochet, and then single crochet into the next petal, so into the chain space. Now we are basically at the corner, so at the corner we will work chain of 19. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 and 18. Then we are going into the next petal and we need to work single crochet into chain space. And again, we've got another two petals, chain of 14, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. Single crochet into the next chain space on the next petal, and now again chain of 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. Single crochet into the next chain space. So now we need to repeat making chain of 14 and then single crochet into the next chain space all the way around. So chain of 14, single crochet into the next petal and then into the next petal. Only on the corner we need to work chain of 19. So we have to make sure that on the top we've got chain of 14 and at the corner chain of 19. At the end of our round, after the last chain of 14, we need to work slip stitch into the first chain, and now we will start round number 2. Chain of 3 as a first double crochet, and now in each chain stitch we need to work one double crochet. So we will work 14 double crochets. Okay, so 1. Oh dear, it will be quite hard on this round. 2. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10. Okay, so now maybe we will work to the end because it's taking too long to show each stitch. So at the moment my work look like that. I've done 14 double crochets into the chain 14 space, so basically one double crochet in each chain. Then we need to work one double crochet into the single crochet, And now we are at the corner. So for the on the first 9 chain stitches, I've done 1 double crochet in each stitch, and now we've got the 10th. So on the actually the center chain stitch, we will work 5 double crochets. So this is only one difference what we have to do. Into the 10th chain stitch, we are working 5 double crochets into the same chain. So I've done 3, 4, and 5, and then again 1 double crochet into the next 9 chain stitches. Then into the single crochet, and again in each chain stitch, in each 14 chain stitches, we have to work double crochet, and in each single crochet to the next corner. On the corner again, into the 10th stitch, into the center one, into the middle one, we need to work 5 double crochets. I am at the end of my first round, so I've done slip stitch into the first chain, into the top of chain 3 actually, into the first double crochet, and now we will start round number 2. So our round, we need to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then chain 1 as a chain 1 space. We need to skip the first stitch, and into the next 3 stitches we will work 1 double crochet. 1, 2 and 3. Chain 1, we need to skip first stitch, and then into the next 3 stitches 1 double crochet. 1, 2 and 3. Chain 1, we need to skip first stitch, into the next 3 1 double crochet. 1, 2 and 3. So now basically we need to repeat this pattern to the corner stitch. So chain 1, skip first double crochet, into the next 3 1 double crochet, 1, 2 and 3. Chain 1, skip first stitch, into the next 3 double crochet, 1, 2 and 3. Chain 1, skip first stitch, into the next 3 1 double crochet, 1, 2 and 3. Chain 1, and now we need to skip first stitch, into the second 1 double crochet, and the next stitch should be our center one. So this is the first one, second and third. Then we will the last 2 stitches, as we've done 5 double crochets in 1 stitch. So this supposed to be the center one. So we've done chain 1, and now into that stitch we need to work, or actually no, yes, we need to work 2 double crochets, chain of 3, then another 2 double crochets, into the next one 1 double crochet, chain 1, we need to skip 1 stitch, and into the next 3 1 double crochet, 1, 2 and 3. So one more time. At the corner we need to skip the first stitch, into the second we are doing 1 double crochet, into the third 2 double crochets, chain 3 2 double crochets, then into the fourth 1 double crochet, and the last one we need to skip again. And then from now we need to continue our pattern from the beginning. So chain 1, we need to skip first stitch, then into the next 3 stitches 1 double crochet. So now we need to keep continue until the next corner, and on the corner we have to make exactly the same as we've done here. And now we need to repeat this pattern all the way around. Because we start our round by working with one double crochet, at the end we should do the last two double crochets and slip stitch into the top of chain 3. Okay, so as I said, at the end we need to work the last two double crochets and slip stitch into the top of chain 3, so into the first double crochet. Now we will start round number 3, and this round we will start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, and now in each stitch, so in each double crochet and in each chain space, we will work one double crochet. So one double crochet, exactly the same as we've done on the first round. So one double crochet in each chain stitch, and now we will work double crochet in each double crochet and then in each chain space until chain 3. On the corner where when we've got chain of 3, we will work 5 double crochets. So the same as on the previous round, on the corner we've done 5 double crochets, and now into the chain of 3 we need to work 5 double crochets again, and then after the 5 double crochets we need to start working 1 double crochet in each stitch all the way around. So in each chain of 3 we need to make 5 double crochets, in each stitch 1 double crochet. Okay, so now round number 4. We need to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then we need to skip second stitch and double crochet into the third one. Actually at the beginning we should do two double crochets together, but because we have to start by making chain, so we've done just the normal two double crochets. Chain of 5, 3, 4, 5. Now we need to skip the next 4 stitches, 1, 2, 3 and 4. First part of the double crochet into the 5th. So we are working only through first 2 loops and the last loop need to stay. Then we need to skip next stitch and into the second again. Only the first part of the double crochet, so through first 2 loops. Now we've got 3 loops on the hook, we can finish the stitch. So we've done 2 double crochets together. Chain of 4. 1, 2, 3 and 4, chain of 5. Chain of 5, we need to skip 4 stitches into the 5th, first part of the double crochet. Then we need to skip first stitch into the 2nd, first part of the double crochet as well. Again, we've got 3 loops on the hook, we can finish the stitch. Chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We need to skip 4 stitches into the 5th, first part of the double crochet, then we need to skip first stitch into the 2nd, first part of the double crochet again. 3 loops on the hook, we can finish the stitch. Chain of 5. And again, we need to skip 4 stitches, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now we will work first part of the double crochet into the 5th stitch, but as you can see, this one supposed to be the first one as we've done in 5 double crochets into the chain space. So this probably is the first double crochet. So now another first part of the double crochet, we are going straight into the 2nd stitch. So we are not skipping next stitch, but we are working stitch next to the other. I've just finished. Now chain of 3, we need to skip first stitch and into the next 2 the same, first part of the double crochet into the first one and first part of the double crochet into the, or actually instead of making chain of 3 we will do chain of 5 as well, and then we need to skip first stitch and then first part of the double crochet into the first stitch and first part of the double crochet into the second. From now, chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we need to skip 4 stitches into the 5th, first part of the double crochet, and again, we need to skip first one into the second, first part of the double crochet. 3 loops on the hook, now we can finish. Chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and again, skip the next 4 stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4, first part of the double crochet into the first stitch, the next one we need to skip, and first part of the double crochet into the next stitch. So apart from the corner, we need to skip one stitch between two double crochets. On the corner, we are not skipping. So chain of 5, 2 double crochets together, all the way around. One more thing. If you will be doing your pattern and you will realize that you've got different number of stitches in the corner, for example, I had 6, just keep continuing, just keep the 6 stitches and then work as normal. So first part of the double crochet, always we need to work into the first double crochet in a chain space. So it doesn't matter if you will have 2 double crochets or 6 double crochets, you need to still work the same. So first double crochet into the first double crochet into the chain, as we've done in a chain space. So it will be much easier for us to continue working the proper corners. At the end of our round, I've done slip stitch into the second double crochet because, as I said, we should have 2 double crochets together. Now round number 5. Slip stitch into the first chain space. Chain of 3 as a first double crochet. Then one more double crochet into the same chain space. Chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One more double crochet into the same chain space. And now we will work 2 double crochets together. So into the same chain space, we need to work only the first part of the double crochet. So we are working through first 2 loops. The last loop need to stay on the hook and then again. Now we need to work first part of the double crochet into the next chain space. So again, we are working through first 2 loops. Now we've got 3 loops on the hook, so we can finish the stitch. So what we actually done? We've done 2 double crochets together, just in the same place as 2 double crochets together on the previous round. So through 2 chain spaces. Actually, on the first chain space, we've got 4 double crochets plus chain of 5, and now we need to repeat. So after the first double crochet, we need to make one more double crochet, then chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, one double crochet into the same chain space, and then only the first part of the double crochet, still into the same chain space. Last loop need to stay on the hook, and again, first part of the double crochet, but this time into the next chain space. We've got 3 loops on the hook, we can finish the stitch. And now again, double crochet into the same chain space, chain of 5, double crochet into the same chain space, and now only the first part. So first part of the double crochet, we are working through first 2 loops, then we are going into the next chain space and first part of the double crochet. 3 loops on the hook, now we can finish the stitch. So basically this pattern we need to repeat in each chain space, even on the corner. So again, double crochet, chain of 5, double crochet into the same chain space. Now only the first part of the double crochet still into the same chain space and first part of the double crochet into the next chain space. We just finished the stitch, chain of 5, and again double crochet into the same chain space, then only the first part of the double crochet. Next, first part of the double crochet we need to work into the next chain space. We've got 3 loops, we can finish the stitch, chain of 5, double crochet into the same chain space, and again first part of the double crochet into the same chain space, and first part of the double crochet into the next chain space. So as we can see, our pattern is the same all the way around. At the end of our round, I've done the double crochet, and now we will work the first part of the double crochet, and with 2 loops on the hook, I am making slip stitch into the top of chain of 3. I've got 3 stitches, now I will finish my stitch. So I've got again 2 double crochets together. Now round number 6, this is the last one round, slip stitch into the second stitch, then slip stitch into the chain space, chain of 3 as a first double crochet, but again we should have 2 double crochets together, but at the beginning I am making chain of 3, and then 8 double crochets into the same chain stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, and now still into the same chain space we will work only the first part of the double crochet. So again we are working through first 2 loops and the same at the beginning of the next chain space. So first part of the double crochet, we are working through first 2 loops. Now we've got 3 loops, we can finish the stitch, so that's what we should do at the beginning. And now again 8 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, then first part of the double crochet, and another first part of the double crochet into the next chain space. We've got 3 loops, we can finish our stitch. And again, 8 double crochets and then 2 double crochets together. So by working this way, this pattern, we need to repeat all the way around in each chain space. At the end of our round, we need to work the last first part of the double crochet, then slip stitch into the third chain. Then we can fasten off and cut the yarn. And that's it. Thank you for staying with me to the end of this tutorial. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you are new. Have a good day.